joining me right now on this and this whole mask mandate issue is the Attorney General for the state of Missouri, Eric Schmitt, who has said he's filing suit against this to get this to stop because this is insane. Mr. Attorney General, it's good to talk with you. Thank you so much for joining us on this. What science is this based on? Because we were told if you get vaccinated, you don't have to worry about the mask. Well, now you got to wear the mask. I mean, the science keeps changing all the time, and heaven forbid we have a discussion about it, because if we do publicly, we're called murderers. If we do online, our social media accounts are suspended. So what is this even based on?
Well, I think, Danny, you've hit the nail right on the head. People are tired of being lied to by the elites in the ruling class, and in a tragic way lost a lot of confidence in this public health bureaucracy. And I don't think the ruling class understands that this is what's people are upset about. Because look, we were told get a vaccine, you don't need to wear a mask. Well, now in St. Louis City and St. Louis County, you got to wear a mask. We know that kids, it's really, really rare for them to contract this in a serious way. As far as, serious health consequences. Now they're being told they need to wear a mask all day long, even though there's studies out there that show the emotional strain, the psychological strain this can have for kids. It doesn't help with learning because of, verbal and nonverbal communication. We were told that Republicans were the reason why there's vaccine hesitation, when the Vice President Kamala Harris on the campaign trail was saying that she wouldn't take it because it was under President Trump's leadership with Operation Warp Speed. We're told by city leaders this is about safety, but yet St. Louis City had a 50-year high in murders last year, and they have a raging violent crime crisis, and their only solutions are defunding the police and have a prosecutor who doesn't show up to court, and literally people charged with murder are walking free. People are tired of the lies and the misrepresentations. And so we filed the lawsuit. I filed the lawsuit yesterday against St. Louis City and St. Louis County to stop these mask mandates. There's no reason in the world why individuals, a million and a half people or people that come into that area would have to wear a mask if they're vaccinated, or kids mm-hmm. need to wear masks all day long. So we're pushing back.
Yeah, no. And I'm glad you are. We're speaking with Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt, who's filed suit here against this, well, St. Louis County's mask mandate. And I'm looking at, like, for instance, some of the information that's cited about this. The CDC came out today and they're recommending indoor mask mandates now nationwide, including in schools, particularly areas they say where they're having a spike in the cases because of this Delta variant. And I feel like everything that we've done, everybody followed, we shut our economy down, everything. And people did what the government said, and it didn't work. And now these cases that they're citing, they keep talking about an uptick in cases, but they don't talk about the severity. They don't talk about the lethality. They don't talk even about the hospitalization rate. They don't even get in the cycle threshold score, which is something that I think the state of Florida was the only one to actually do that when they were getting all of their cases together. All of that stuff. My point is, all of that stuff is super important. Has Sam Page, who is the county executive for St. Louis County, and that's the first area that's done this, hence your suit, has he included any of this information? Has he made any of this information available to you and anyone else? Is St. Louis County just special and that they are just there? What are they based? Again, have you gotten any of this? Has there been any transparency?
No, and two things that I think are important. First of all, the legislature, because of the shenanigans that were happening in St. Louis County, in other words, passed a law basically saying, hey, you got to get council approval or it expires in 30 days. The council can revoke. They're actually working this order to try. Now, they've got a big hearing tonight in St. Louis County. I'm sure there's a lot of people that are going to show up to try to get around that new state law, which tells you everything you need to know about how they know the public actually feels about this. And St. Louis County had the most restrictive regime in the whole state until we sued them, and they changed their, reversed course 3 days later, 2 months ago. You still had to get the government's permission to have an outdoor barbecue with your friends. And by the way, their numbers were worse than Franklin County or Jefferson County that didn't have any of those restrictions. St. Louis City, we're finding out now when you peel back the onion, maybe one of the reasons why they issued this emergency order and proclamation was they were at a stalemate on how to spend millions and millions of dollars of federal money with the Board of Aldermen. Now, all of a sudden, the mayor may not have any oversight at all because she's declared the state of emergency. So there's a lot more to come on this. But the truth of the matter is, there's no reason under God's green earth why vaccinated people in St. Louis County should be required to wear a mask, nor should kids have to wear a mask all day long. That's not science. That's not facts. That's making it up as you go along, and people have had enough of it.
I think so. We're talking with Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt. He's filed suit challenging this mask mandate that first came from St. Louis County. Now a number of other states, different localities in other states, have copied what St. Louis County has done. And then, of course, we get these CDC recommendations today where they say that they're encouraging masks now again in schools and in places where they have the Delta variant. How do you think that this is going to go now, telling, you know, parents, not just in Missouri, but across the country, oh, everybody's got to mask up again? I just feel like that's not going to go over very well with parents.
People don't, it's not good. And by the way, this has, we don't even know. I mean, there's some preliminary studies on the psychological and emotional harm this has for kids. And we actually cite that in our lawsuit as a reason why this is completely arbitrary and capricious. But it's going to take years for us to figure this out. And, you know, you see what the CDC is doing today. And I hope that's not just political cover for these blue cities that want to continue to exercise outsized control. They got used to it. They liked it. They found out they could do things without a lot of oversight. They had immense power under these emergency powers. And here we go again. So this is more about control to me than it is about public health.
No, I agree with you. Talking with Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt, people were told if you get the vaccine, then you can go out without a mask. But if the vaccine isn't doing what it was advertised as to prevent the spread, how do you think, sir, that is going to go in encouraging more people to get vaccinated? Because to me, these mask mandates are just saying, oh, well, you know, vaccine really isn't working. I mean, that's just the message that they're sending out. How is it going to encourage people to get vaccinated?
Well, that's another great point that I brought up yesterday when I was talking to somebody. Is that, look, this is going to have the opposite. I hope it doesn't, but it could have the opposite, you know, impact that they want to have. Like, these are totally mixed messages that they're sending right now. And I don't know if they view it as some sort of, like, social experiment that, like, you know, we don't have vaccination rates the way we want, so we're going to punish people now, and everybody's got to wear a mask. And until, you know, I don't know. But the reality is vaccines are widely available. If you got the vaccine, you know, you're not going to get – the odds are it's extremely unlikely that you're going to, you know, get seriously ill or die from the coronavirus. That's Operation Warp Speed, right? That's President Trump's leadership. And so to now kind of reverse course, I mean, Joe Biden was just saying a couple, you know, weeks ago that, you know, go about your life. You've got the vaccine. You know, how has that changed? How has that changed in 2 weeks? That's, again, why I think the public trust in a lot of these institutions, like the CDC and others, has fallen dramatically, because there's completely mixed messages. It looks like politics has gotten involved in this. And people just want to know, what are the answers? What is the science? And, you know, it's pretty clear if you're vaccinated, you don't need to wear a mask. You don't need to wear a mask. But here we are now with, you know, these situations where people are going to do it. And you got the government mandating every woman, you know, man, woman, and child over the age of 5 to do it. That is overreach. That's heavy-handed. People don't like it. And that's why we're fighting back.
Yeah. We're talking with Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt, and on this mask mandate. And this is so, I mean, this is such a big thing. I know a lot of governors have, you know, like, and I know Governor Mike Parsons in Missouri's done this, Governor Greg Abbott in Texas. Now there's, you know, they're making it to where you can't force people to have to wear a mask, or, and I know that they're also standing against mandatory vaccines as well. But do you really get the sense that that's kind of where this is being pushed, is for mandatory vaccinations or having a vaccine passport? You know, which the thing that gets me is the people that are opposed to IDs for voting have no problems with IDs for vaccinations or requiring proof of vaccination to move about the cabin, so to speak. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no, we should not have vaccine passports. In fact, the legislature came in, it kind of anticipated, like most legislatures across the country, they end, you know, in mid-May. So they were trying to anticipate, deal with some issues. They wanted to make sure that governing bodies like county councils and county commissions had some recourse against, you know, a public health official that could have unlimited powers forever, right? So they allowed them to come in and kind of veto this, which is going to play out, we'll see, in St. Louis City and St. Louis County soon. But they also banned vaccine passports. So those are good things. It's hard to say where they want to go with this, but it ought to concern people that the left views this almost as a religion, and their ability to control the movement and behavior of people. We know a lot more than we did, certainly, you know, a year and a half ago when everybody was, you know, trying to understand what this was. There is a vaccine. It's widely available. This is, you know, in many ways about personal responsibility. The government should not be dictating all these things to everybody. And these local governments, particularly in these blue cities, I think they're going way too far. And people are going to, they're frustrated by it. And I think the backlash is coming.
Yeah, I think so, too. And I think especially, you know, the backlash is coming. And I really think that people are going to be questioning even more these bureaucrats, because I see people that are on the left that have the same complaints I do. And that's, you know, that's when, you know, everybody stops and kind of looks at each other and like, we all agree. That's how bad this is. Like, we all agree. Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt. Well, we'll please keep us up to date as to, I mean, I know we're going to be following it in the news, obviously, but please keep us up to date about this suit that you have filed against this mask mandate in St. Louis County. And we're going to watch other areas, too, where this is happening. We appreciate your stand for freedom, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Dana.
Of course. Take care.